He was exhausted. He sat at the very edge of the hotel bed. The mattress sighed into his weight as he sunk into it. He had learned long ago never to lay down on the bedspreads of these old fleabag motels, since they were the last thing that ever got replaced, putting in years of service before they were discarded, and were so rarely cleaned by whatever was likely to pass as a housekeeping staff in these Bates motel-like haunts. The edges of it yellowing and frayed like his brain felt these days. He wondered how many others had sprawled out on this bed, maybe in drunken turpitude with the rank smell of sin and gin, and an apathy that insulated the psychic pain in their souls, like asbestos, while their bodies went through the animotions of what those dainty, daisy-chain-minded members of a higher social strata might call making love. Yeah. Few high-minded people would call it fucking, unless they were trying to impress their Facebook friends with their street cred on that worldwide circle jerk known as the web. It was a web, too. Look at his wife. She was ensnared by it, spent almost every waking hour planting fake crops in places called Farmville, and talking about chocolate dildos for Easter with a bunch of equally small-minded, fat-assed, middle-aged housefrows who suddenly rediscovered their former prom queen selves in the miracle that was online life. While he busted his hung hawk and shit nobody wanted to buy anymore. Namely himself, going from town to town, conference to conference, feeling older and more useless by the second. To his wife, he figured he was nothing but a human billfold. Something to be pulled out only when she needed it, just so much cock and cash. To his fellow travelers in the business of selling information, he was a dinosaur. He may as well have been hauling vacuum cleaners door to door, like the smarmy sales guys used to in those old 50s flicks. Nobody wanted to listen to his spiel. They were all too busy texting their latest Twitter-pated thoughts to listen to him when he did his due diligence. Visits. They now all got their information from online prospectuses and contacts from LinkedIn via email. Maybe if you were lucky, they'd include you in the generic communiques. A phone call would be like an act of God. Hell, if his cell phone ever rang, it would probably startle him into a coronary incident. The party that was his industry in the go-go days of the bull boom were long since over. Nobody wanted to meet with anyone anymore. Nobody needed to. Everybody used the same strategies, charts, vendors, through computer networks that cost nothing, and everyone was privy to the same useless information. His was a dying breed with the firm handshake, the square chin, the bellowing laugh, ready smile, and ironclad liver. He could drink the Nile, pee out the Irrawaddy, and swim in the Danube, while his clients were all passed out under the tables. These things were considered virtues, and many a deal was struck up on your ability to break 80 on a golf course, buy the guy a bottle of Dom, and provide him with a tasty hostess-style cupcake for the meat of the evening's entertainment. But now, everybody stays in their rooms, surfs for porn, and saves their company the expense. Still, he was a traveling man. Like that old Ricky Nelson song his mother played over and over in that beat-up old Magnavox recorder, record player, while she sat there in the dark smoking herself into shadows, just a gray haze of ether and sad madness. The song sent him on a freighter to paradise, let's see. There was a pretty señorita in Mexico, an Eskimo in Alaska, a Fräulein in Berlin, a China doll in Hong Kong, and a Polynesian in Waikiki. Yes, sir, a woman in every port, from Bangor to Brussels. Never really happened to him, but it sure was a pretty fantasy. Fuck it. He needed that drink. He wanted to go down, now, hard. His Sherwood Forest had been chopped, logged, and burned for kindling a long time ago. He was all ashes and no smoke. He pulled out a bottle. He pulled a bottle out of the briefcase that he placed on the bedside table, knocking the cheap wire lamp over. It's now bare bulb glowering at him, accusingly, from the floor. He left it there. He opened the bottle, pouring the first ounce straight down his throat. Yep, that was his theme song, Monk Straight, No Chaser. The tunnel of dark opened to the freight train that was running in his head, and the long night wore on.